Those of us who work in technology, particularly in the areas of security and reliability, are very concerned about the elections because the electronic voting machines that are used don't produce a hard copy record that can be audited or recounted if there's a question about the election. Our concern is that those systems could be tampered with, but more likely there are errors in the software, some of which have already shown up in previous elections. And if that were to happen, we can't have a do-over, the election's done. For a close election, this throws things into considerable doubt, possibly into the courts to decide, which isn't really the intent of the voters. Most election officials are honest and trying to do the best job they can, and most of the equipment is reasonably good. So most elections are going to turn out appropriately, and the votes are going to work. The problem is that we don't have control over that. It's a Murphy's Law kind of thing. And what may in fact happen is that in a national election, there is a race that is closer than people think. It hinges on perhaps one state's electoral votes to determine who the president is. And within that state, it turns out that there are only a few hundred or a few thousand votes that make the difference. And if it's all conducted on electronic machines with no backup, there's always going to be doubt. And if some of the precincts show very skewed ballots, as happened in Florida back in 2000, then it's going to cause real political controversy, alleging that one group or another stole the election, altered the machines, or otherwise. And it could cause a real political crisis in the country. We do know how to have technology in place that produces a paper version of the vote in addition to the electronic version, that the user can verify and ensure that the paper copy matches what they intended and what's shown on the screen. And then after the election is over, if there's any doubt, or as a check on the electronic voting, we can do a recount of these paper-based ballots. The best form of this technology, for those of us who've studied the issue, is what's known as a precinct-based optical scan. And this is where either you vote on a computer system that prints a ballot that shows the information you want, or you manually fill in a ballot with a marker or pencil or other device, verify that it shows what you want, run it through a scanner at the local precinct, which will detect if you have voted incorrectly. Maybe you voted twice for the two different candidates in a race or failed to vote for a candidate. But once it determines that you voted correctly and you accept that vote, it deposits the ballot in a box, as well as making the electronic copy. It has the benefits of voting machines that we can detect if votes are cast incorrectly. It allows quick counting. It doesn't have the error of human counting. But at the same time, we do have the paper ballots as backup in case there's a question, in case the counts come out very odd in some respect, or a close election, or someone questions whether the technology was working correctly. So we have it as a backup and a verification. It isn't that much more expensive than the systems we're currently using, and in fact, in some places, it's less expensive than the systems that are in use. But it requires replacing systems that are already in place.